Hey guys, this is MJ Nichols from Internet Money, and today I'm going to be showing you exactly how Metro Boomin produced the instrumental for Mask Off by Future. I know there are a couple of other videos kind of breaking down Mask Off on YouTube, but they didn't quite nail it. This is an exact recreation of the instrumental for Mask Off. So what I'll do is I'll move all of this to the side for now, and I'll start from scratch so you can see exactly how Metro Boomin produced the beat. So first things first, when I started this recreation, I set the BPM to 150, that's the tempo of Mask Off. And here's the sample that Metro Boomin used for Mask Off. It's Prison Song by Tommy Butler. I'll play just a couple seconds of it so you can hear what the original sounded like. The first thing I did was I chopped up the sample, stretched it so it would fit the 150 BPM. Then after that, Metro went in and tuned the sample down 2 semitones. Now here's what Metro did in the intro to kind of give it that lo-fi kind of pulsing effect. The first thing on the effect chain is Fruity Love filter. I have it set to the basic preset under gate. And then what I did was I dropped down the mix level down to about 55%. You can kind of hear it gives it like a phasing, swirling effect. After that, I put on gross beat. I went to the momentary preset bank and then put it on half speed. And then the last thing for the intro was taking out some of the low end and then some of the high end, around 3300 hertz. So that's all the intro consists of. He just repeated it for 4 bars. And then once the beat comes in, he uses the same sample. I'm gonna make this unique and then set it to the second mix track where all I have going is an EQ. Just taking out some of that low end and just a tiny bit of the high end. So now we get to the drums. All of the drums that were used in Mask Off are just basic trap drums that are in countless different kits. For your convenience, I've zipped up the drums that I used in this project, and there's a download link in the description where you can download them from. Basically just consists of a clap, a snare, the rack kick, and spins 808, and a hi-hat, and that's it. So first we'll go over the clap. What he did was he put it into the project and then pitched it down 1 semitone. So you can see the clap is tuned to B4 instead of C5. And then after that we have the snares. Then we get to the kick. The kick's super simple. There's just 1 kick on the downbeat on the first bar. Then we get to the 808, which alternates between D5, C5, and G5 at the very end. And then lastly, we have the hi-hat for the first half of the verse. It's just a simple 2-step pattern. And now we get to the second half of the verse, which is pretty much just the same half, except there's just a couple different variations in the drum pattern. First of which being the kick now, there's 2 kicks, both on the first downbeat, instead of the just 1 in the first half. For the 808, instead of going up to the G5, he went up to A#. And then the hi-hat pattern gets a little more complex with some triplets thrown in. And then lastly, for the bridge, he uses the same intro for four bars and then just takes a different portion of the sample for the last four bars. So there you go. That's exactly how Metro Boomin produced Mask Off for Future. I hope you guys picked up a couple things with this beat breakdown. The main thing that I took away from it is all of these hit songs you hear on the radio, a lot of times are just super simple beats. You don't need to get too complex with things. A lot of times us producers like to put a lot of effort into our beats, a lot of extra work to try to impress other producers, but it's just that. You're only impressing other producers. Sometimes it's best just to go completely simple, but catchy. That's also important. Anyways, that's it, guys. If you guys want us to break down another beat, whether it's our own or another person's beat or song, let us know in the comments down below. If you liked the video, consider giving it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to the channel already, consider doing so. We're uploading daily content to help you producers improve on your production. And with that being said, I will see you guys next time.